Hi dear students, welcome to my channel. This video is useful for 8th standard onwards. Okay, keep watch forward, you will understand very clearly. Okay students, in the previous video, I discussed work kinetic energy theorem in the presence of force of kinetic friction. How the change in kinetic energy differs when force of kinetic friction is there. That you understood, no? Some three important points I will tell you. Work done by force of kinetic friction is always negative. Remember this. Okay? Some two more important points. Work done by force of static friction can be positive. Okay? Now one more important. Work done by force of static friction can be negative. Be careful. The work done by force of static friction can be negative, can be positive. But work done by force of kinetic friction is always negative. Okay? One more is there, rolling friction. That I did not explain it before, but I am giving you as information. The work done by rolling friction is zero. Okay? This rolling friction we will discuss in rotatory motion. Full details. Okay? Now I am switching to new topic, that is power. Work done, work you understood, I hope. W equal to F dot S. What is meant by power? Okay? Power is simply rate of doing work. Time rate of doing work. What is this time rate? Suppose I am taking this ball from here to here. Means I have done some work against gravity. Okay, suppose it has traveled some 40 centimeter in 1 second. Okay, this is work done in 1 second. Suppose I am doing very fast in half a second. In half second I came from here to here. The work done is same. But power is different. Means I am doing work in 1 second from here to here. The power is less if I take from here to here in half a second. Agree? I will give some more example, easiest way. Suppose I am taking from here to here in 10 seconds. That is power is P1. From here to here 5 seconds. That power is P2. So P2 greater than P1. You are doing work very quickly. Means you are powerful. Powerful means you are working very fast, efficiently. That is called power. Okay? In this video, you know, you will understand about power, its units. Okay? Watch forward, you will understand very clearly. This is class number 78. Power. The definition is the time rate of doing work is called power. SI unit of power is joules per second, also called the watt. James Watt, who invented steam engine, the name of James Watt, we are using this watt as a unit for power. 1 watt equal to 1 joule per second, that is 1 kg meter square per second cube. Okay, now we will do average power. Average power is equal to del W divided by del T. This del W is amount of work done in a time interval of del T. Okay, see here, work done on the object will increase the energy of the object. We are doing work on the object, no? Then energy of the object will increase. That is nothing but power is time rate of energy transfer. This way also we can define the power. Okay? Now we will discuss instantaneous power. Instantaneous power means in average power, del W by del T, no?
As time interval tending to zero, it will become instantaneous power, P equal to limit del t tending to zero, del w divided by del t equal to, it will become dw by dt. This dw is nothing but f dot ds, force into displacement. So I can write f dot ds by dt. Ds by dt is rate of change of displacement, that is velocity. So f dot v. So instantaneous power we can write dot v. Okay. Some important points I will tell you. A unit of power in the British engineering system is the horsepower, HP. 1 horsepower equal to 746 watt. Unit of electrical energy is 1 kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt hour equal to 1 unit. In our daily life, we will pay current bill to the power supply company. How we will pay? I will solve one problem. You see here, find the total amount of money paid to the power company if 60 watt bulb run for 300 hours. Given 1 unit equal to 3 rupees. Why I choose this problem? In my childhood, in my home, 1 bulb, 60 watt Surya bulb was glowing. Okay. Average every day, night only we will use 10 hours per day. 30 days, so 300 hours. So if it is glowing 300 hours, how much money we have to pay? That we are going to calculate now. Now we are going to calculate how much amount we have to pay for the power company. Because that 60 watt bulb was glowing 300 hours, that is approximately 30 days, 1 month. Because every day 10 hours it is glowing, no? So total electrical energy consumed. So 60 watt bulb. So 60 watt into how much time? 300 hour. So it is 18,000 watt hour. 18 into 10 to the power of 3 watt hour. So 10 power 3 is kilo. So kilowatt hour. So 18 kilowatt hour. Kilowatt hour is 1 unit. So 18 kilowatt hour is 18 unit consumed. So 1 unit price is given. For 1 unit cost is 3 rupee. For 18 units cost is 18 to 3 54 rupees. Total amount paid is 54 rupees. You got it? Please like this video, share this video and subscribe my channel and tap the bell icon to get the notification for further uploads of my videos.